Let's step back for a moment to the very beginning. It all started right here. After World War I, the government decided to allow radio, which to that point had been a military communications tool, to be used commercially in order to communicate with the general public. This government-owned resource, spectrum, more commonly known as the airwaves, is the platform on which broadcasting and wireless communications industries are built. Now, in those early days, as technology progressed, it became possible for moving images as well as voice to be transmitted over the airwaves, creating what we now take for granted as radio and television networks, as well as the film and record industries. But let's not skip over an essential factor. Each spectrum-based industry created wealth and power for those licensed by the government to use spectrum for doing business. Now, let's be clear. The rules that determined who would be given the privilege of using the government spectrum for commercial purposes were formulated at a time when blacks were purposefully denied economic participation at all levels of American society by racism, Jim Crow laws, public and private policies, as well as the legacies of slavery and its structural socioeconomic inequalities. As a result, the broadcast industry began with 100% of the broadcast opportunities set aside for whites only. Now, how's that for affirmative action?